You are watching M.A.T.O. episode 21. It's another week. Major Awesome here. Relatively small haul this week, but I would say it's an impressive haul. So got a package from my buddy Rick Valdez. So in the package came the Crossbones, a very difficult figure to get locally. Impossible almost. So here I have him with Juggernaut. So slowly but surely I'm building up a Thunderbolts team. Not very popular with Hasbro. So you know, I probably have to get a few of the Thunderbolts members custom made. So Rick, besides sending me Crossbones, he gave me a freebie. So he sent me the DCUC Mercury figure. I'm not really a fan of the Metal Man. But hey, you know, I think the Mercury character is quite cool. Comes with an interchangeable hand. Simple sculpt, but you know, interesting features. Moving on, so Rick also sent me an Ares figure. I'm actually referring to the Marvel Legends Beth figure. So he's complete with his sword and a dagger. Very dope figure. And coincidentally, you know, Mr. Jax sent me another package that coincidentally came with the DCUC Ares. So two depictions of the same God of War, from the Greek mythology, but from very different storylines. The blue Ares from the DCUC line is the nemesis of Wonder Woman. So very colorful, you know, typical DCUC character, very colorful, very nice detailing. You know, Mattel can do very good figures when they choose to, and I think this is a very good example of that. He comes with two accessories, a sword and an axe, and the axe fits onto his harness pretty well. So quite a nice figure, you know, very nice contrast to the Marvel Legends figure. You know, one came at a very reasonable price, the other cost an arm and a leg, so go figure. Yeah, the Marvel Legends Ares would be more prominent in terms of being featured in the comics, whereas the Ares DC character, you know, I don't ever recall having seen him in the comics. So definitely one is literally colorful, whereas the other one is figuratively colorful. So the Marvel Legends Ares is an Avenger. You know, he later on becomes a Dark Avenger as well. So, you know, he appears in the comics quite frequently. So another figure that came from Mr. Jax is the Night Shadow Batman. Very nice figure as well. Here I have him posed with Nightwing. So very nice features, you know, simple but yet very stylish at the same time. In fact, I was just thinking that this figure would make a very nice base figure for a Black Panther figure. Yeah, I mean, especially the mask, don't you think it kind of looks like a Black Panther? So, yeah, you know, worth considering if you have a spare Night Shadow Batman, you could convert him into a custom Black Panther. Another figure that came from Rick, the Quicksilver figure. So here he is, I have him posed together with the Brotherhood of Evil Mutants. So slowly but surely, my Brotherhood of Mutants display is growing. Here I have him together with Scarlet Witch. You know, Scarlet Witch, as I talked about previously, is was my worst Marvel Legends female figure of all time, but she has since been matched or even superseded by the Spider-Woman figure. So here I have her posed with Quicksilver. I think Quicksilver makes the Scarlet Witch figure look good. So yeah, credit to Rick also for... Oh no, sorry, not Rick, but Mr. Jax for sending me this. And then very quickly moving on, something I just received in the mail today. So this is the Azrael figure from the old line, the DC Superheroes line of toys. Also a very impressive and rare figure. So the thing with DC figures is that they do not have ankle rockers, so I kind of have him in this pose. I would say this is my money shot. A very cool character, you know, very top heavy, nice detailing with the cape and the torso. The legs, as usual, are pretty plain. Nice effects, fire coming out of his gauntlets. Very nice hood. Overall, a very nice figure. I would say out of the scale of 10 on the awesomeness scale, I will give him a 9. Yeah, very quickly, I should give the other figures a scale as well. So I think the Night Shadow Batman, simple but yet also pretty impressive. I'll give him an 8 on the awesomeness scale. Ares, both Areses would get about, I would say, an 8.5. Mercury gets about, you know, pretty plain overall. I would give him an 8. Crossbones, 8.5. Quicksilver, 8.5. I would say he's quite a dope figure also. So yeah, you know, very simple episode this week. Nothing too fancy. Yeah, I mean, small haul, but as I mentioned, very, very impressive. Quite a number of very rare figures. So, that's it. Major Awesome. Signing out. Take care. Till next week. Ciao.
That's crispy.